Hey historians, welcome to the most exciting day yet. Mia and I are gearing up for the ultimate race. A race not just to the finish line, but to the very stars above us, the final frontier. It's not just us competing today. We are joined by the two superpowers, the United States and the Soviet Union, as they battle it out for the ultimate achievement for their nation, winning the race to space. So, let's take a look at our mission plan. First, we're going to identify how all of this started, how rivalries on Earth sparked a contest for the final frontier. Then, we'll relive the breathtaking journey to the moon, seeing firsthand the innovation and spirit it took to make that great leap for mankind. And finally, as we orbit the moon and gaze back at Earth, Mia and I will reflect on our incredible journey together. This is it, team. The countdown to our greatest adventure begins. Let's see how far we've come and how far we still can go. Ready, Mia? Let's make history. Let's take a moment to understand how this incredible race to space began. Picture this. The world has just emerged from the shadow of World War II. Peace has been created, but it's fragile. Two new superpowers, the United States and the Soviet Union, find themselves locked in a standoff of opposing ideologies and ambitions. Based on what you've learned about the Cold War, why do you think the US and the Soviet Union both cared so much about going to space? Both countries wanted to be the best at everything, to prove that their way of life was superior, whether that meant having the largest army, the biggest weapons, the most advanced technology, or being the first to reach the moon. In this climate of rivalry, a single event in 1957 shifted the focus skyward, marking the start of the space race. The Soviet Union launched Sputnik, the first artificial satellite, into orbit around the Earth. This wasn't just a triumph of technology, it was a statement. Space was the new frontier, and the Soviet Union had taken the lead. Imagine how it must have felt to see humanity reach beyond our planet for the first time. How would it feel if the country that did it was the one you feared the most? The US saw Sputnik as a threat. If the Soviets could send rockets to space, that meant they could also send nuclear weapons to the US. So, in response to Sputnik, the US kicked off its own space program, Project Mercury. This project aimed to send an American man into space orbit and bring him back safely to Earth. President John F. Kennedy, with the eyes of the world upon him, soon made an even bolder promise: to land a man on the moon and return him safely to Earth before the decade was out. This wasn't just about reaching the moon, it was about proving what free societies could achieve. The US needed a huge and brilliant team to achieve this goal, and so NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, was born. Scientists, mathematicians, engineers, and astronauts worked together to catch up and pass the Soviets in this epic race. Every astronaut, engineer, and scientist who contributed to the space race shared a dream: to reach beyond the known, to explore the unexplored. It's a great example of how the challenges we face can often have really awesome outcomes. Okay, historians, it looks like we got to NASA at just the right time. The rocket set for the moon is about to launch. Let's see if we can sneak on board. We made it on board the rocket! Mia, we are about to experience one of the most monumental moments in human history. After years of hard work, innovation, and exploration, humanity is on the brink of stepping onto the moon.
Five,
oh, the countdown starting.
Four,
buckle
three,
up, Mia.
Two,
here we
one,
go.
Zero.
On July 16th, 1969, Apollo 11 launched from Kennedy Space Center, carrying astronauts Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins. And then, on July 20th, 1969, history was made. The lunar module, Eagle, touched down on the moon's surface. Neil Armstrong stepped out and said those now legendary words, "That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind." Buzz Aldrin joined him shortly after, and together, they explored, conducted experiments, and planted the American flag. Why do you think the moon landing was an important moment in history? This wasn't just an American victory, it was a victory for all of humanity. The impact of this achievement went far beyond those first steps. The moon landing showed what we, as a species, are capable of when we work together toward a common goal. It was a testament to our technological capabilities, our determination, and our dreams. I think it's time to get out of this ship and take a spacewalk. Mia, let's get out of here. Wow, being on the moon is epic. But Mia, look at Earth. Now that is a beautiful sight. Looking back at our home from way up here makes me think about everything we've learned on this journey so far. Throughout our course, we've traced the journey of our nation driven by the values of democracy and innovation, a journey that led us, all of humanity, to where we stand today. As we've traveled through history together, two themes have emerged as the major threads connecting many of the events we've studied: democracy and free market economies. From the moment the ink on the U.S. Constitution dried, America has been shaped by its commitment to democracy, the fight to preserve the Union in the face of civil war, the challenge to stand against tyranny during World War II, and the journey to ensure equality for all its citizens are stepping stones that have defined America's role on the global stage as it has fought for democracy. How do you think the space race fits in with these examples of democracy? The space race demonstrates how a democratic society, with its emphasis on equality and collaboration, can achieve significant milestones. It also represented a victory for democracy in the Cold War, showcasing the ability of democratic nations to take the lead in global technological advancements. The second theme in our course is free market economies, which are systems where businesses operate through competition with minimal government interference, encouraging innovation and growth. We've seen this at work many times in the last 200 years of history. For example, the Industrial Revolution. During this period, inventors and businesses competed to create new technologies like the steam engine and railroads, transforming how we live and work. This competition drove rapid economic growth and technological advancements. Then there's the post-World War II economic boom. After the war, the United States saw unprecedented growth. With innovations and competition, America's economy flourished, showcasing the power of a free market to rebuild and expand prosperity. How do you think the space race can be seen as a positive example for free market economies? The space race is another brilliant example of this theme. When the US reached the moon, it was a victory for free market economies over communism. And the investments in NASA and space technology not only led to significant innovations, but also bolstered the economy by creating jobs and inspiring a new generation of scientists and engineers. As we stand here reflecting on our course from the early beginnings of America to its position as a global leader during the space race, let's carry forward the lesson that our history is not just about where we've been, it's about where we're going, about the dreams we dare to dream and the frontiers we strive to cross. And as we conclude our journey through history, let's not just look back at what humanity has achieved. Let's look forward to the new horizons we can explore together. Let's dream big, Mia, for ourselves and for the generations to come. Because now that we understand the past, it's up to us to start shaping the future.